Hi, I'm Kaioki Kilu. Here's your Channel TV news update for September the 3rd, 2020. The military says it has recorded more gains in its fight against banditry and other criminal elements in the country. According to the defense spokesman, General John Enenja, the troops have killed four armed bandits at Jagadarabi area along Kaduna Abuja Expressway. In Abuja, the Director General of the National Youth Service Corps, Brigadier General Shoaibu Ibrahim, has announced plans by the service to revisit cases of ex-corps members who served under the scheme fraudulently. Speaking at a meeting with officials of the Independent Corrupt Practices Commission in Abuja, Brigadier General Ibrahim explains that those found culpable will face prosecution. The move, according to him, will help rid the nation of corrupt-minded persons. Nigeria has recorded 216 new cases of the coronavirus disease in the last 24 hours. The Nigeria Center for Disease Control, NCDC, says the cases were recorded in 15 states and the Federal Capital Territory, Abuja. On the international scene, the American Democratic presidential candidate Joe Biden has called for charges against police who shot two black Americans, Jacob Blake and Breonna Taylor. Speaking in Delaware, Mr. Biden did not specify what counts should be brought in the cases, which have fueled racial justice protests nationwide. And in sports, world number one Novak Djokovic overcomes a slow start to beat Kyle Edmund 6-7, 6-3, 6-4, 6-2 to remain unbeaten in 2020. Edmund took a tight opening set, laying down an ace to clinch the tiebreak 7-5. And that's the news update. Don't forget to join us later for the recap. I'm Kaioki Kilu. Thank you for watching.